Okay, office tips are like jokes in a comedy club. You go to a comedy club, you laugh all night, and the next morning you can't remember any of the jokes. It's like, there was a funny, I can't remember. So what we're going to do here is we're going to give you a ton of jokes. We're going to give you a ton of office tips, and you may not remember them, but we're going to throw them all on the blog for you, and you'll be able to see those later. We're just going to give you as many as we can in 15 minutes. So I don't know if you're counting at home, but we're going to begin right away. So I'm going to slide over here and start with Word. The first couple tips I'm going to do, these work for all Office programs. And the first one is if you need help, you click F1. F1 opens up information for it goes specifically for whatever program you're in. So this is just help for Word 2013. And look, right here, I can go to keyboard shortcuts and see what's new in all this for Word 2013. I don't even have to listen to the webinar. I can just, please listen to the webinar. The next tip, every time I say everyone knows Control X is cut and Control V is paste, they say, I didn't know that. So I have to show that. But right below is, I think, really more, even more important, which is Control Z is undo. So if you didn't like what you just did, hit Control Z, 1, 2, and I'm right back to where I was. If I want to redo that again, it's Control Y, and I could just do Control Z, Control Y all day and actually not get any work done. The Alt key makes everything a shortcut. So you may have done this before. If you press the Alt key, you get these little funky letters at the top of your screen. That's if you don't want to use the mouse or can, if you're injured, you can do everything with a keyboard shortcut. So that letter at the top means I can go to there. So if I want to go to this picture tools, that's JP at the top. You see that? So I'm going to type JP. And now every single command is just a click away with a keyboard shortcut. I want to go into the picture styles, which is K. Then I'll use my little arrows. I can pick which one I want. And boom, I've reformatted that picture. Hit enter and I'm ready to go. Shift F7 is your thesaurus. This is for Pad, who's standing by answering your questions right now. This is his favorite. So if I hit Control F7, Shift F7. There's a mistake right there, our first one. Shift F7. I get this thesaurus that pops up. So if I need to get another word, and I can just choose it right here, insert, boom. Type first, format later. This is for folks who, if they're my age, they grew up with typewriters and they're always thinking they have to format first, or kids, they get too concerned about centering and fonts and all that. Just get everything typed and then you can format it. A great way to format right quickly is starting with Word 2010. If you go to Page Layout, your margins are right here, and we've put some of the most popular ones right there for you. So if you want to make your document have narrow margins or normal margins quickly, you can do that. That's a really great time save. You don't have to worry about numbers or rulers. And finally, because I know I'm late on time, if you go to the File menu, you can find the older copies. So if you notice here, there's been actually 7 versions of this document. I'm going to let this click over and then we'll go right to the next one. And I can click on any of these and find an older version if it's something that I wanted to get. And that's going to trade off. See, that's under File, Manage Versions. And that's for Word. Now, Dave, take it away.
All right. We'll just head on over to Excel, everyone's favorite spreadsheet program. Okay, I've got a big set of data here. How do I select this range of data without scrolling too much? I can go over and then hit Control Home to get to cell A1, the topmost leftmost cell. Control Shift right arrow selects everything to the right. Control Shift down arrow selects everything down. Okay. Let's go further here. Let's hit Control Q and we bring up these analysis features here. And I'm going to peek into tables, pivot tables, because people get squeamish about those. Go ahead and hover to see a pivot table. Okay. I like this one. I'm going to choose that because it shows me sales per country here. Okay, so that's a quick way to get a pivot table. To format as currency quickly, Control Shift dollar sign. Okay, and then to make a pie chart, or a chart, I should say, quickly, Alt F1. Okay, and you can always change your chart type if you need to. Okay. There we go. So let's go back to this data set. This is a big gnarly data set here, and to work with it better, we should make it a table. So Control T for table, okay? Hit enter, and there you've got a table with auto filter menus and a frozen row at the top here. Let's go forward here and let's do more with tables. One thing you can do with tables is you can make power views. So we'll go over to the insert tab and then we'll click power view. Okay, and that'll open a new tab in your workbook. and it will generate something similar to a pivot table. Okay, it doesn't look great now, but if you exclude the certain fields, and again, sales amount by country, that looks great, and then you can map it and show your sales plotted around a world map, thanks to Bing Maps, okay? Let's go ahead and switch on over to PowerPoint. How many times have you looked a blank PowerPoint presentation in the face like this, okay?
Yeah, lots.
It's very daunting at times. So if you're text-oriented, go to View and go to Outline View, okay? And then each one of these nodes in this Outline View over here on the left is a slide. So you would probably start with a welcome slide and then an agenda slide. And then perhaps you're gonna talk about what's working, what's not working. You've all been in this kind of a meeting, right? QA. So you can use this outline mode over here on the left. You can go further, type enter, and then alt shift right arrow to give yourself a bullet on that slide. Okay, and then you can type in your agenda items. Okay. So that was alt shift right arrow, and then alt shift left arrow can outdent things. Okay, let's insert a picture on our welcome screen. Let's make a fun welcome screen here. So yes, you could go to online pictures and insert something from Bing Images or office.com clip art. But you know, everyone has a cell phone now, it seems like, and lots of cell phones have good quality cameras. Why not make one yourself?
Even yours.
Yeah. I inserted a, I took a picture of this coffee cup here on my desk. I'm going to go ahead and make it big so that it fills the screen. Okay, I'm gonna send it to back. I'm gonna say, grab some coffee. We'll start at 9:15 a.m., okay? And then I'll select both of those, make the text color white. If I can find it, there it is. Okay, and I'll move these guys, oops. I'll move these guys over, there we go, over here. And then now we have a nice welcome screen to start a presentation. Let's go even further and be a little more creative. Let's turn this photo here into a posterized version of it. So we'll go to Format and then Artistic Effects. And my favorite effect is this cutout effect here. It reduces the bit depth of the photo, and you can even go further and go to Artistic Effect Options, change the shades to 6. I recommend that. And now you have sort of an arty welcome screen here to welcome your guests to the meeting. Okay. Let's go over to Outlook.
Sure.
Everyone's favorite email program.
I say sure like I'm doing anything. I'm just sitting here.
Okay.
Sure, go over. Start working.
All right. So you navigate often by clicking these big buttons down here to go to calendar, going to people, going to tasks. Okay. Well, another way to do that is Control-1 for mail, Control-2 for calendar, Control-3 for people, and Control-4 for tasks. Okay. We'll go back to mail here. Let's say you have a, when I pull up a new message, Control N, like new message, we'll bring that up. Okay. And if you want the address book, Control Shift B, like address book, B as in book. Okay. Choose a recipient and then you're good to go. Now, what about autocomplete entries? Sometimes you start typing and someone's name comes up, and sometimes that's helpful and sometimes it's not. Let's say I don't want Jeff to come up here. I could click this delete button if I want to, and then he'll never be suggested again. Or I can hit the delete key on my keyboard and he will never be suggested again. So we'll escape out of that. Let's go on over to the calendar.
It's a little mean-spirited.
Yeah. Well, you know, sometimes you send something to a customer service department and you don't want that to show
up. Sure.
Okay, so we're in the calendar here. Sometimes you've got events that don't happen on a consistently recurring basis. Sometimes, you know, your poker night here, it's on Saturday, but maybe next week it's on Friday, and the next week after that it's on Saturday, and the next week after that it's on Thursday. Well, to handle that, I click the first instance of it, make sure it's time and location's right, hold down Control, and then I drag that over here to the date the next time it occurs. So this week's on the 23rd. Okay, then I drag to Saturday, and then all these varying days, I can just drag it to those particular places on
Control
the calendar.
Control drag, right?
Control drag, yeah, that will copy that guy over. Another way to quickly insert things or add things to the calendar is to go to list view, okay? And now, if you make sure that this option is checked, show new item row, you can enter appointments in here as if it's almost like a spreadsheet. So here's poker night, okay, location, Dave's Cave. And we set the time. We could even put in here 9 p.m. Okay, 10 p.m. That's actually a pretty short poker game. But you get the idea. Press enter and it's added. And you could do another poker night here. Enter another poker night here. Okay, so that's entering things easily in the Outlook calendar. And are we moving over to OneNote?
We're moving over to OneNote.
Okay, great.
Unless you want to explain why I'm not getting invited to poker night. okay, so let's move over to my favorite program, which is OneNote. The first thing is the format painter is awesome. If you don't agree with that, just leave the room right now. It's on most of the Office programs. So this Word has a lot of different formats and fonts and all that. I go up here to format painter, I click it once, and now my icon turns to this little paintbrush. And anything I select with my mouse is automatically turned that way. If I want to keep doing that, I double click the format painter, and every time I select a word or select a bunch of words, it changes to this until I hit the format painter again. It is an amazing thing. It came to OneNote in 2010 and changed my life. Okay, next up is, if you ever have a piece of paper that you have to retype and you don't have it virtually, you only have it a physical piece of paper, take a picture of it, put it into OneNote. Right-click, and this has to be legible. It can't be chicken scrawls. It has to be something like this. It's pretty legible. I'm going to right-click this picture. There's a thing that says copy text from picture. So I'm going to copy the text. I'm going to go down here. I'm going to paste it in. I'm just going to paste it in. And there's all that text. Now, it's not going to be 100% accurate. There's a couple things, but I'm not the fast typist that Mr. Ludwig is, so I cannot type that fast, so at least this is giving me a great start. Also, both of these are now searchable in OneNote if I ever need to find this. Don't cut and paste, use send selection. So most people know about the scrapbooking feature, so which is Windows S. We can show you this in the Q&A if you need to see this. I'm going to grab this picture of this handsome couple. Now, I can send this to the copy board. That's a regular cut and paste, but send a selected selection does a couple different things. I can put it literally in any of these notebooks. I can put it in any pages. I'm going to pick my current page, and wherever the cursor was, it's now going to send it there. So let me go back to OneNote. There's the picture right where I have my cursor, and there's the data right there at the bottom. The URL and when the screen clipping was taken is right there. You know you can put audio and video into OneNote? Didn't know? Let's just start a recording. I'm going to break something right now. Alt-N-A starts a recording. We're now recording audio. If you have to do it for lecture notes or whatever, you can do that right away. It stays with your notes. I'm going to stop. If you want to send this page to email, hit File. I think I put the shortcut up, but File, Send. You can now email this page to folks. It opens up in OneNote. All my stuff is there, the pictures, the formatting, and also that soundbite I just did, that's an attachment in the Outlook. So if you need to send your meeting notes to someone right away, they don't have to have OneNote, but you can keep all that formatting right there in a OneNote message. There's a lot more, but I think we're going to run out of time. So I'm going to actually wrap this up, and we'll have these tips, I want to say, in the next hour at aka.ms/waterfall. Go there. We'll have all the tips in the comment section. And that way you don't have to remember everything we just did. But hopefully you are now drenched with Office tips and time savers. Find more about the Office webinar series at aka.ms/offweb. Our upcoming, we've listed about the next 5 or 6 webinars to be there. But for now, next week, talking about why you use styles in Word. But for now, for Dave, Doug, Bruce, Pat, and Chris, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.